Hello, everybody. The Lawn Gnome is here. First one that got away of 2019, it is actually two films that got away. Now, were these films that I was dying to see in theaters? No, not really. But part of me, especially the true film appreciator, is trying so desperately to find myself truly great comedies once again. I don't know what has happened, but in the last 15 to 20 years, there has barely been a comedy that has truly appealed to me, and more importantly, has truly gotten me to laugh. But today we're going to be talking about two that came out this year that I sort of had some interest in. And the first one that I want to talk about is the movie Game Night, which stars Jason Bateman, Rachel McAdams, and one of the best character actors outside of Bruce Greenwood and Jason Clarke. That would be Kyle Chandler. This is the story of a couple that is just fiercely competitive and loves to have game night with their friends. And one night, Max and his wife Annie, who of course are played by Jason Bateman and Rachel McAdams, find out that his older brother, who he never truly got along with, is coming to visit. And he is always known as this better person, while Max is just known as the average of the two. So one night, they all get together at his brother's house that he is renting and decides that he wants to kick game night up a notch and really turn it into something even more lifelike and challenging. And basically, it turns out that a lot of his life that he had been telling everybody was a flat-out lie, and he's actually a wanted man. And game night turns into something that I don't think even the greatest competitors, Max and Annie, could have anticipated. And that's basically what game night is all about. Now, I've got to tell you, this was given to us by the creators of one of the better comedies that I saw in the last couple of years, and that is Horrible Bosses, which ironically also starred Jason Bateman. So I had some high hopes, and while I feel that this movie was not a truly great movie, it wasn't terrible. I found myself extremely entertained. There were definitely some moments where I laughed, and there were even some characters that really, really got me laughing even harder. Jesse Plemons, who as far as I'm concerned is Matt Damon's doppelganger, plays the creepy neighbor who was shunned from game night because he was the part of a divorced couple that Max and Annie and their friends did not care for. But his yearning for game night is just so weird and unsettling, you cannot do anything but laugh at this character. Some of the things that they get into in regards to game night are definitely over the top, but sometimes over the top can be good. The whole part that you've even seen in the trailer where Jason Bateman's character is trying to remove a bullet from his arm and his wife doesn't really know how to do it and they put the squeaky toy in his mouth, it still was very funny. So yeah, I had a good time with this movie. It definitely didn't make me laugh as much as I wanted to, but I have to give it credit for its creativity, and especially with game night being an extremely popular thing in American culture right now, it was definitely interesting to see a great twist on the traditional game night. Is it a movie that I would want to see again? Well, if my friends wanted to get together and actually watch game night on a possible game night, why would I say no? I'll watch it again. But is it a movie that I would want to buy on DVD? No, I would not want to add this movie to my collection. So I'm going to give Game Night 2.5 stars out of 4. But now let's talk about the second comedy that I saw that I definitely don't want to see again and definitely do not want to add to my collection, and that is Blockers, starring John Cena, Leslie Mann, and Ike Barinholtz. So this movie, you know something? I don't even want to be fancy with this. Blockers was great the first time I saw it when it was called American Pie. This is the story of three individual girls where one of their fathers, another one of their fathers, and one of their mothers think that they should become friends because their three daughters are very, very good friends. And they are about to go to prom, and the girls decide that they want to have a sex pact and get laid on prom night. Sounds very familiar, don't you think? But when the parents accidentally intercept some messaging, they realize that they gotta prevent their girls from doing this because they are having trouble letting go that their kids are officially becoming adults and that they are gonna have to, at some point in time, cut the cord and let the birds fly free. So This movie was stupid. I thought it was terrible. I thought that there was no value in this. I didn't even laugh. And some of the things that happened in this movie were flat out pathetic. Not just that, there is so much political correctness in this film. It's sickening. And because of the fact that it's in there, it just makes this movie so less appealing than it should be. The fact that they personally try to push feminism, the fact that they personally try to push lesbianism, it didn't seem natural. It seemed forced. And these things can easily work in a movie, but because of the fact that this is done horribly, directed terribly, acted even more horribly, this movie just doesn't work. I mean, the girls that are really the main focus of this movie outside of the adult actors, I didn't find them funny at all. I didn't even care about their presence on screen. There was nothing in this movie that made me enjoy it, and I am so upset that I saw it, because this is basically telling me this is where comedy is going. It has to be extremely politically correct. These ideals have to be thrown down people's throats, and you're gonna have to like them. We don't care if you laugh at them or not, but they just have to be there because we need to make sure that people accept it. Well, you know, the more you push these ideals on people with force and not give people what they really want, a great story, great characters, and overall a good movie, you're never gonna win that battle. I'm sorry. I am more than willing to accept all of these things as long as they are done properly, and more importantly, not demonizing those types of ideals. It's one of the main reasons why I have high hopes for finally seeing movies like Love, Simon, because I've heard great things about it. I heard that it was directed beautifully, and even though it is about homosexuality, it's about people being treated like people, and that's what I really want. This did not do any of it. And I do enjoy John Cena and Leslie Mann. I have seen them in so many other movies that I enjoy, but in this one, I didn't appreciate their characters at all. Comedy is ruined, everybody. You can't be offensive, you have to be politically correct, and if you can't laugh at yourself, why even laugh at all? So I am going to be giving Blockers 0 stars out of 4. There is nothing in this movie that I enjoyed. This movie didn't even give me a chuckle. That's how bad this movie was. Don't even bother seeing it if you haven't yet. So thank you very much, everybody. Please leave your comments in the box below, and let's discuss either Game Night or Blockers, both or neither, and if you want to throw some hate my way, bring it. I'll see you in the next one. Hey, thank you so much for stopping by my channel today. If you're new here and want to see more of what my channel has to offer, please click on the link to my last video or hit that subscribe button to be kept up to date with all of my uploads. Content of all sorts is posted here quite often, so trust me, you do not want to fall behind. I will see you in the comments, and actions speak louder than words.